When you think about a classic Land Rover Defender, you think about the ruggedness and what it can do off-road and how it can take you wherever you want to go. You probably think it doesn't have technology, it doesn't have the creature comforts, and it would not be the ideal daily driver. Well, in this video, I'm going to show you what we do at Helderburg Defenders to give you those creature comforts and the technology so it becomes a modern daily driver, but it still has the great classic looks. The first thing that I want you to notice about a Helderburg Defender is how we keep all the classic look, but we're putting new technology, modern things into the Defender, but it's not necessarily apparent unless you really know Defenders. The first thing I want to point out that's not standard that you won't find on other Defenders, at least the classic original Defender, is the front bumper with the LED driving lights. So during the day when you're driving, people are seeing you because these are a brighter LED light. Again, this is not standard. So when you start the truck up, these automatically come on. You don't have to flip a switch, they just come on. Later in the evening, when it starts to get dark, when you need to use the headlights and you turn on the headlights, then these LED driving lights go out. Another thing about the LED driving lights of what they do is when you pull up somewhere and you stop and you turn off the truck, these lights will stay on. This is like a safety light, allowing you to see the surroundings, making sure nobody's around, and where you can get to where you want to go. The next point is the headlights. The headlights are actually LED too, so they're very bright. They are the DOT maximum brightness light. They're at 6,000 Kelvin, which means that it's a very bright white light like the sun. So the throw on them, it's got a long throw, meaning that you can see much farther down the road. So if you're actually off-roading or you're in the country or wherever, you're going to be able to see if those deer are playing in the road farther up or if somebody's broken down. It also has a wider throw because it's a dual filament LED light. So you can see on either side where it has LEDs on either side. And what it does is it puts light on the side of the roads. So then, therefore, if deer or critters are playing on the side of the road, you have a much better chance of seeing them. But the way the LED is designed, it's not blinding the oncoming traffic where people are flashing their lights at you. So this is a very modern design, allowing you to see down the road. Again, this is not standard in a Defender, because standard Defenders, what they have is have an incandescent bulb, which is this the old-time bulb that doesn't light very well, and they don't last very long. So this is going to give you the type of lighting that you would expect in a modern-day Mercedes-Benz or a Lexus or something like that. So great lighting. Moving on to this, turn signals and marker lights. So on the front and the back, you'll see that this is a clearer lens, but whenever you turn the turn signal on, it actually lights up orange. The marker light is actually a red light. So just because it looks clear, the LEDs behind this screen are the proper color. The way the LED is designed is it emits the light. So oncoming traffic from far away is more likely to see that your turn signal is on. So again, all the lighting is very, it's for your safety, it's for the brightness. So it's to make sure that you have all of the modern conveniences when it comes to lighting. So now let's move to the back of the vehicle and talk about the LED lighting on the taillights. Now that we're at the back of the Defender, there's a few things going on. Again, you're probably not noticing it because we're staying with the classic look, but taillights. So here it is, clear taillights again. But when you step on the brake, it lights up red. When you turn on the turn signal, it turns orange. Again, LED lighting gives a lot of benefits. One of the benefits is the light comes on faster. So when you step on the brake, it comes on quicker for the people behind you to see it that much faster so they can slow down a little quicker. Versus the classic Land Rover Defender, what they offer, incandescent bulb, which is a bulb with a filament, which is very dim. It doesn't transmit the light very well, and it takes longer to actually turn on. So with the LED, again, like I told you at the front, it's sending that light signal out. It's like a laser light is what it is. So people farther back are seeing that you're starting to slow down, starting to brake, or you have your turn signal on. But let me draw your attention to something else, because what if you don't want the clear lenses? You don't have to have that. That's just part of the bespoke process. Bespoke meaning custom built. So when we're building your Defender, that's some of the questions we're asking you. Do you want the clear or the smoke taillights, or do you want the classic red and orange taillight and turn signal? Again, these are LED also. It's just we keep the classic look. Part of the way we decide that is personal preference, but it's also what color of the vehicle. Do we want a little pop of color? So again, you have a lot of choices in the bespoke process. So continuing on with this one, it also has a third brake light in the rear window, and it's also LED. So you have a lot of lighting going on for when you're coming to a stop, so no one rear ends your beautiful Defender. All right, let me move you back because we're talking all about lighting here. If you notice right here up high, we have an LED work light. So this light, there's a switch right inside the rear here. You flip the switch and you're able to do whatever, whether you're hooking up a trailer, whether you're camping, or whether you're just trying to get some things out of the back and trying to light your path. So more LED lighting. Inside the truck, the LED lighting continues on. So in the back in the cargo area, you have LED lighting along the sides that are hidden into the headliner. So when you're in the back and you're trying to gather stuff later in the evening, you're able to see the lighting. Also with that LED lighting, you're able to see into the back of the truck when you're coming up to it to make sure there's no one inside your truck if that's a concern. So LED dome lighting, LED side lights. Continuing on with the LED lighting is the instrument cluster. And again, all of this I'm talking about is not standard on a Defender. So the instrument cluster, where your speedometer's at and your clock and your gas gauge, that's all LED backlit. So it's very bright, but I say very bright, it's not blinding you, but it's bright that you can actually see the instrument cluster, which is a well-known fact on Land Rover Defenders that you can never see your gas gauge or your speedometer because the lighting is the old school lighting with a bulb and a filament, but we fixed that problem. You also have your courtesy lights that are inside the footwells, again, lighting the area. And then another option that we offer you is puddle lights. So you've probably seen that on modern cars. When you come up to the car, it has a light that's coming down that's lighting right beside the door. We have that option, you've probably seen it, where it actually has the logo. And yep, guess what? It has the Helderburg logo that shines beside the car so you can see how to get into the vehicle. It's called a puddle light. Plus, LED lighting lasts much longer than a standard lighting. And the bulbs, the replacement is very easy and very expensive. So if you have a light that goes out, which would be several years down the road, a replacement light is a few dollars. Now let's move on to the camera system that comes with the Helderburg Defender. So one of the things you definitely don't want to do in your Defender is back into somebody else's car, because you're going to create a tremendous amount of damage for their car and none for yours. So what we've done is we've put a backup camera system. So right here, above the windshield sprayer nozzle, that's what this is, above it is actually a Pioneer camera that has parking lines. We also offer a secondary camera that goes onto the passenger side that mounts either to the roof rack or the body. This allows you to parallel park much easier because when you're pulling into that spot, you can see the curb to make sure you're not scuffing a tire or a wheel. Again, the system is actually putting it on the 7-inch, a 9-inch, or an 11-inch screen in the center console, so you're able to see exactly where you're at and see everything around. So we've made sure, we've made it easy to park a vehicle, and it's not that it's a large vehicle. I mean, a Defender is about the length of a Chevy Colorado, but it is a little taller and they are heavy. So at over 6,000 pounds for one of these vehicles, there is a lot of weight moving down the highway or moving down the road. So therefore, let's talk about the braking power and what we've done to that to move it from that classic Land Rover Defender that's doesn't stop so well to where it will stop on a dime. So before I get into the braking, let me talk about wheels and tires just briefly. So again, part of the bespoke option, the custom build, is you have a choice between various tires and a lot of different wheels. So this is called the Sawtooth wheel, which is an anniversary alloy wheel. Highly popular, but again, we have 16 different wheel choices. So what comes standard on Helderburg Defenders is a four-wheel disc braking system. This is not the norm for Defenders, because a lot of other Defenders, what they have is they have drums in the rear and disc in the front. Drums are old technology. A drum just doesn't stop as well as a disc. So with our four-wheel disc system, what we've done is we've put bigger rotors. So the rotor is much larger, meaning that the surface is more. And then we have larger calipers with larger pistons. So you have the caliper that holds the piston, which holds more fluid. And then when you step on the brakes, this piston's pushing out against a larger brake pad, against a larger rotor. So you have more surface that's touching per square inch, meaning that it's stopping the vehicle quicker, and it's stopping the vehicle in a straight line versus the drums. You could end up, when you're trying to brake, that the back end could break into a skid, and it just doesn't stop in a straight line. Disc usually don't do that. It's a much more controlled stop, and again, the per square inch of the rotor is much larger on the Defenders that we're doing, meaning that it's going to stop it quickly. That would be our basic braking package, and we do have additional braking packages so we can move up from there. In fact, we have three different braking packages, so you can continue to get larger disc, larger calipers, and more pistons. But our standard braking with the four-wheel disc, the larger caliper, the bigger pistons, is totally fine. You don't need to upgrade, but if you want to, you can, because you can even get different colored calipers. And you've seen it on sports cars where the caliper could be red or orange or whatever. We can do that on a Helderburg Defender. So since we're talking about brakes, let's talk about the ride comfort too. And part of that is talking about wheels and tires. Again, I told you we had 16 different types of wheels and we have different tires. So one of the things that we're doing to give you a better ride is it's a modern tire. This is called a BF Goodrich KO2, which gets a very long mileage. It's good in the rain, it's good in the snow, it's good in the heat. It's an all-around great tire. And while it looks rugged, it's not a noisy tire. So it's a very controlled tire, and when it comes to noise, it's a very controlled tire when you're trying to stop quickly, but it's a great tire when you decide to go off-road or go onto the beach or whatever. It will get you where you need to go. So again, tires make a big difference in the ride comfort, and we offer different size wheels and tire packages. So right here, this is a 16-inch, which this is pretty standard, and you can go up to an 18-inch or a 20-inch. Again, we have a lot of different choices. So why I'm telling you that is you'll notice on the 16-inch tire, the sidewall, the point from where the wheel goes here to the point up here, there's a lot more rubber. So this, where you have more rubber, what it does is it's a little more of a not an off-road ride, but more of a four-wheel drive ride. Versus on Elizabeth, on the green Defender, you'll see that it's an 18-inch wheel, so the rubber is actually less, meaning that it's that the wheel is taking up the room to bring the truck up, but it's lowering it down, and it's allowing, instead of the tire here, that can give a little bit of wiggle at the high weight speeds. You're not going to notice it. I mean, this is just where we're testing all the time. The shorter tire, the 18-inch tire, which I know sounds counterproductive, but the 18-inch tire actually gets the wheels closer to the road and gives you a more steady ride. So Elizabeth is more of a sports car ride, when this one is more of a four-wheel drive ride. So now let's move to the suspension, because that's part of the bespoke program. You have three different options in suspensions, and it makes a big difference whether you're going off-roading or whether it's going to be a daily driver. So at the front of the vehicle, you probably see something that's different, and that's the ride height between these two trucks. So starting with this one, this is considered a beach cruiser, a beach truck. So what we've done with this is we put a terra firma suspension in it, meaning that the springs are a little taller, not taller than normal, but they're a little taller than this. So this truck is designed as an all-purpose, well-rounded truck, meaning that you can go out on the beach and you can go off-road, you can have a lot of fun with it, but you can also put the family in it and take a trip 300, 500 miles and show up and not feel like you're beat up. It's a very smooth riding truck, but it's also designed for the beach or off-road. Again, that's a terra firma suspension that's in this truck. So well-rounded, all-rounder truck is what it is. Moving over to Elizabeth though, where it's 1 inch shorter, what this one has is a Bilstein suspension. So this is a performance suspension. This truck is designed for the long haul. meaning that you can get in this and you can drive it for 800 miles and you show up and you still feel fresh, that it's just coasting on the road. So by lowering it 1 inch, we've put a progressive spring in it, meaning that it's designed to handle the road, not so much for off-road. It will do it. I mean, it's fine, but that's not its ideal environment. Again, this is to get on the highway and go and get to your destination doing 75 to 90 miles an hour with a nice, comfortable ride. That's the way that's designed, with the Bilstein suspension and the progressive springs all the way around. So as you see, suspensions, these are both different, but they will serve purposes. Again, this one's dedicated more of the beach cruiser. This one's dedicated more of the road cruiser. So there's a lot of different options. We even have another version, which is the version that raises the truck up. And that's the truck that if you want to be in Moab or use it as a dedicated hunting truck, it's going to get you through the craziest type of environments that you can find. So since we're talking about road cruisers, let's talk about some other options that are available on a Defender that you won't find on most other Defenders, especially the classics. Cruise control. So if you're going to do those mega miles in a truck like this, you probably want cruise control. You probably want power windows and you probably want power door locks. So those are all options that you can do in the bespoke program. So again, we're making it convenient to make sure that you have everything that you want. While this isn't technology, I'm going to point this out though. So in the Defenders, in our Defenders, in the Helderburg Defenders, which is pretty standard, is heated seats. So we offer heated seats in the front and heated seats, which is an option for your passengers in the rear, the second row. So let's assume for a moment that you wanted to take this truck, as I do, and you want to take it camping and make it multi-purpose, but you don't want to leave it running and you need that extra power. Power for your laptop, your mobile devices, whatever it might be, or refrigerator. Well, you're going to be draining the batteries down, so that's why dual batteries. But to keep those batteries charged, we offer a solar panel system that goes on the roof of the vehicle that is more than efficient to keep a really good charge on those two 12-volt batteries. So you're able to go through the night and use the solar panel that's charged the batteries. You don't really have to be concerned. And then the next morning, when you continue your trip, you start the truck up, the alternator will continue to charge those batteries, which is another option, is alternators. So we offer an alternator package, which is an upgraded alternator that will produce more power, charging those batteries quicker. So I've explained a lot about the stopping power and the lighting to make sure that you can see where you're going, but now let's talk about performance upgrades for the motor so the truck is fast. So probably the biggest question I get is, how fast is it? Can I do highway speeds? And I will tell you, if you are in a traditional Defender, they're slow. There's no denying it that they are slow. But to make it comfortable to drive, we've done a lot of performance upgrades to the engine to make sure that you can reach those highway speeds and maintain them for a long time. So we put a lot into the suspension and the braking and the lighting, but can you get up to speed? And the answer is definitely yes. So Elizabeth or Baird or whatever, any of these trucks, yes, you can exceed the speed limit. You can stay with the flow of traffic, meaning that you don't have to pull over into the right lane and let everybody pass you. That's not a thing with a Helderburg Defender. They are fast. And fast is a subjective term, so I'm not going to tell you that one of our Defenders is going to run with a Mustang 5-liter or anything, but it's fast enough to get you in trouble and get a speeding ticket. So let's put it that way. So what are some of the things that we do? The first thing that we do on it is a turbo. All of our Helderburg Defenders are 300 TDI motors, which is a diesel motor. It's a four-cylinder motor. And the reason that we only do the 300 TDI motor is because it's absolutely bulletproof. These motors can easily go for a 500,000 miles with minimal repair. It doesn't take much. And the best part of it is they're super easy to work on and they're highly reliable, which I want to just talk about reliability for a second. A lot of times, we think, or individuals think, that a Land Rover is not dependable. Well, you are correct. A Land Rover is not dependable because they've added all the electronics. But there's a difference. Land Rover Defender is dependable. It's the Land Rover Discovery that's not dependable. If this was not a dependable truck, then you would have not grown up watching this vehicle on Mutual of Omaha where they're out in the safari and they're in the desert and they're taking these excursions where there is no services, no parts, no mechanics, no one to help them. It's a very reliable vehicle. It does not have a computer in it, so anyone can work on it. You don't have to find a Defender mechanic. You could actually take it to a shop where they work on a John Deere tractor, Kubota tractor, Massey Ferguson tractor, or a tractor trailer that's hauling stuff down the highway, and they can work on this very simple motor. The parts are very easy to access. There's numerous places in the United States to be able to get these parts, and the best part is they're very inexpensive. To do a water pump and a belt on this truck is $117. You won't find that on anything else, any other vehicle, modern vehicle. But again, highly reliable 300 TDI motor, and it has a turbo. Classic Defenders, if it's a 300 TDI, it has a turbo, but it's a smaller turbo. So what we do is we use an Alley Sport turbo. We've tested it, we've proven that it's a great turbo that has a very long life. And with the larger turbo, it's creating more brake horsepower, more torque, that it's giving you that extra, well, basically that extra power to be able to get down the highway faster and to be able to tow things. So turbo is an option that we offer in the bespoke program. You go to a larger turbo or stay with the standard turbo. The next thing that we move over to is called a Turner Performance cylinder head. The cylinder head is what sits on top of the motor, and that's where the fuel injectors are at. That piece of equipment on top of that motor has more moving parts than the entire rest of the engine. So it's really important that if you want that additional performance upgrade, you go to a Turner Performance head, which is an aluminum head that's been ported and blueprinted, meaning that all of the cavities in it are getting more water in, getting more exhaust out, and getting more fresh, cold air into the motor, creating more of a combustion opportunity, meaning that it's giving you more horsepower, more torque. So turbo, and then the Turner Performance head is going to give you more power. And then what we do is we talk about a custom exhaust, again, a bespoke program. The custom exhaust system, well, it doesn't really change the sound of the vehicle that much. If anything, what it does is it makes the vehicle a little quieter. It brings the noise down a little more. But what it does is it allows the motor to get rid of that exhaust gas quicker, meaning that it's creating more torque and more horsepower. So now we're on to three options: turbo, cylinder head, exhaust. The next part, what we do, is called a boost pin and a boost ring. And that's an option. If you want a little bit of performance, we would put a boost pin and a boost ring and then forget all the other parts, and that's going to give you more power. So that's how we're getting power out of the motor. Now that we're generating more power, your question probably is, well, are we taxing that engine? Are we putting too much to the engine? And the answer is no. What we've allowed it to do is we've made that engine able to perform at its capacity, meaning that it's breathing freer, it's rolling freer. It's actually going to help the longevity of the motor is what's happening. And then what we've done is we've moved to the front where the radiator's at. And here's another bespoke option, is we have an Alley Sport radiator, which is called the XL radiator, meaning extra large, which is a high capacity radiator. It's aluminum and it has more fins in it, meaning that it's getting more cool air to the motor. It's a big improvement when you do that. The next part of how a turbo actually runs, and this is standard on all of our Defenders. When you buy one, you automatically get this. And right in this section under the hood is called an intercooler. The intercooler is what's taking the cold air in, and it's putting that cold air through the turbo into the motor. So we use what's called an Alley Sport quad core intercooler, meaning that it's getting more air, cooler air, faster, again, generating more horsepower and more torque for the vehicle. By us doing those simple upgrades, now this vehicle is generating a lot more horsepower, a lot more torque, and surprisingly enough, it's actually increased the miles per gallon. So in a truck this size, you can expect to get into the mid 24 to 27 miles per gallon on this diesel motor, and it has an extremely long life. Again, 500,000 miles, not a problem, it can do it. And then further on, if something happens, if you decide, well, you know what, I need to, if the motor's done for or whatever, a complete motor rebuild on this truck is around $4,500. So it's a very practical truck. It makes a lot of sense to have a truck like this because it's the do anything type truck while you're still looking cool. So it gives you the functionality of a minivan or an SUV, but maybe I'm a little partial, but I think it looks a heck of a lot cooler than any one of those vehicles. So continuing on, since we've talked about now, we've talked about the motor and how we're generating more horsepower and more torque to be able to pull items. What about the transmission? So you have two options in the transmission. The first one, which is I will tell you and I will beg you to stay with it, is the manual transmission. We've done a lot of work to this manual transmission. It's called an R380. It's an Ashcroft transmission, which Ashcroft is the benchmark when it comes to English transmissions for the Defender. They can take a tremendous amount of abuse. And if you've never driven a standard transmission, this transmission is the ideal transmission to learn how to drive a standard transmission. The reason being is because it has a very low end gear, meaning first gear and second gear is very low end. So if you're in a lot of traffic, like if you're in a very metropolitan area with a lot of traffic, it's a very easy truck to drive with the manual transmission. We've put additional springs and we've put additional clutch slaves into this transmission that it is so easy to actually step on the clutch and let off the clutch. You can do it with two fingers, seriously. Two fingers and you can push the clutch and let the clutch out. It's that easy. The beauty of the manual transmission on a Defender, though, is it keeps the soul. And I tell you, these trucks have soul, but it keeps the soul in the truck. They are extremely fun to drive. And even though you've been spoiled with an automatic transmission, I highly encourage you, start with the manual transmission, see how much fun it is, see how enjoyable it is, and I think you're going to stick with it. But if you are just hell-bent and said, I have to have an automatic transmission, we can do that. We can provide the automatic transmission. Again, it's an Ashcroft automatic transmission, so we can do that. We can provide that for you. But again, I say do the manual transmission first, drive with that for a few months, and then if you decide, no, I don't want it, then it's easy enough that we can ship the automatic transmission to your town. We'll find a mechanic for you that will put it in. It's a very easy conversion. It's about a 10-hour job, so it's easily done if need be. So talking about the performance, the motor, the transmission, you're probably thinking, all right, you said it's reliable, but how reliable is it? Well, we think it's so reliable that all Helderburg Defenders come with an unlimited nationwide warranty. So unlimited mileage nationwide on them for 1 year. So if you drive it 100,000 miles, it's still covered. We will cover it against engine failure and transmission failure, and it's a nationwide warranty. So that's how confident we are that these are stupid reliable and will take you wherever you want to go and won't leave you stranded. All the parts and the components that we've added in a Defender and to the Helderburg Defenders are modern technology. They're new advances. We're just keeping the classic looks, the classic lines, but we're giving you all of the creature comforts and the technology and the performance that you need and you want in a vehicle. And especially when you're paying this type of price, you want something that's going to be able to get you where you want to go and when you want to go. That's what the Helderburg Defender is all about, is the classic design with the modern conveniences.